This followed a concern raised by Jennifer Muhuruzi, the acting director, Treasury Services and Asset Management at the Ministry of Finance, who urged Parliament to ensure that 227.56 billion shillings is availed in the 2023-2024 national budget for the redemption of the promissory notes that were approved by Parliament to Enrica Pinetti, the proprietor of Lwoa Hospital, so as to ensure that government meets its obligation on time.
So what we have revised is the promissory notes agreement, and this is the one that is going to operationalize the project works agreement.
Both of them have been revised. Even the project works agreement has been revised.
While scrutinizing the documents before Parliament's Finance Committee from Treasury Operations, a body charged with management of Uganda's debt, Karim Masaba, the MP Imbale Industrial Division, tasked the Minister of Finance to explain the discrepancies in the amount to be paid in the promissory notes. Masaba disclosed that amendments are reducing the scope of work at Finance Construction.
You're reducing the work they are supposed to do, and you're increasing the money that is supposed to actually be paid to them. So do you think that is fair to this nation?
There was a promissory note,
yeah,
and then the execution agreement.
Yeah.
And the promissory note, the Parliament authorized, I think, up to $379 million.
The question is, this Parliament guided, yes, in terms of the nature of work.
Is it the agreement? Because if it's the agreement that we approved as Parliament, then you cannot vary it without recourse to Parliament.
Following this revelation, MPs called for another scrutiny into the original documents and the current agreements that government has entered into with Pinetti, and called for the cancellation of the contract if it is discovered that the proprietor did not honor her part of the deal.
If Pinetti did not deliver on the contract, then what should have happened was a cancellation of the contract. But we have carried on with a contract which has not been executed according to plan, but we continue to pour in public money. That's where I have a serious disagreement.
The hospital was meant to carry 54 oncology beds, 27 infectious disease beds, 27 medical beds, 16 VIP beds, 8 intensive care unit beds, as well as 60 outpatient beds, 54 surgery beds, 27 pediatrics beds, 27 OBGYN beds, 16 intensive care beds, 8 neonatal ICU beds and 11 operating theatres. However, Henry Mosasizi, the Minister of State for Finance and General Duties, asked the committee to schedule another meeting to discuss the issue of Lwoa because he hadn't come with a technical team at the Ministry of Finance that is overseeing the project.
I want us to discuss Lwoa when we have prepared for it and we have Minister of Health in the room and all other stakeholders, even the staff. We have some technical staff who specifically sit on the desk of Lwoa, who have worked through these agreements.
Meanwhile, the Finance Committee has lashed out at the Minister of Finance for refusing to avail within the budget for Treasury operations funds for the Democratic Republic of Congo war compensations to a tune of 248 billion shillings, warning that this could attract further litigation for Uganda.
You carefully avoid putting a figure, but here in unfunded priority you have a figure of 133 billion,
and because we can't wait, this needs to be decided on, because this is a very important vote, that it's a commitment that the Accountant General cannot even afford to default even for one day.
In February 2022, the International Court of Justice ordered Uganda to pay DRC $325 million, approximately 1.165 trillion shillings, in reparations for resources plundered during the UPDF deployment in DRC. The UN court castigated UPDF for breaching the international law and ordered Uganda to pay the money in annual installments of $65 million so as to clear the compensation fee within 5 years. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.